Good afternoon, everybody. It is Meteorologist Ains Weather Forecast here, and welcome back to the update, guys. As you can tell, we're not going to be doing a winter or fall related video because, again, we have finished fall and winter week. We will be still having some more videos coming in like those, but again, they're not going to be day after day. They might have maybe every 2 days or every 3 days having a video like that. But guys, I just got back home from school, and I hope you guys are ready for today's upload. Today it's going to, we're going to be doing like a US forecast on the extreme heat for the south and the cool down for parts of the west here. We're just going to be looking at the weird pattern that's continuing to occur here. We're not going to be focusing on the heat or the cold. We're just going to be looking at a US forecast again, just to see what we can expect, because it's gonna start getting a lot colder for central in the end of August, but right now we're getting a lot of warm air. And again, we are gonna be seeing this cold August start to get a little closer day by day, but we still need to finish off this last heat front or this heat wave. So if you guys want to know if you will be affected by the heat, or if you're going to get affected by the cold, or both, that'll come right up. And also, guys, I forgot to mention, don't forget to like and subscribe, too. Be sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel, and like the video. Let's get it to 15 likes. But, guys, we're going to be looking at the National Weather Service right now. We're going to be taking a look at all these right now, but we want to be focusing right here. Let me switch colors. Right here, we want to focus right here because we have heat advisories now. They actually went from the southern tip of Texas to widespread in the deep south, in the southeast. So it's actually really, really hot right now. I just got back from cross-country practice. It was extremely hot, but not too hot like here in the south central. So we actually have heat advisory stretching from all the way to Georgia through widespread through the deep south, and then a little part here for the southeast, and then we actually have some more for the panhandle and for parts of the Carolinas. So we're gonna have some extreme heat. It's gonna be incredibly hot for the next couple days. We just need to get over. Once this heat wave does end, we will have some more cold fronts start to come in, so that's to look forward to the cold August at the end. But if you're in the orange, you're in a heat advisory. And then we also do have some special weather statements out here for Texas, Southern Texas, and Southwest Texas. We also have in the dark green, we have flash flood watches, so that's where we can expect some heavy rainfall there for Northern New York and parts of the South Central, Colorado, and Idaho. All those areas in the dark green will expect flash flood watches, and we have flood warnings and flash flood advisories out here. For the central part of the United States, we have severe thunderstorm warnings in effect for the northeast. There, we will have some strong storms with a slight chance, and severe thunderstorm watches for much of the coast, northeast coast. We have some red flag warnings out here for parts of the Pacific Northwest. We also do have lake wind advisories there, and then we also do actually have severe thunderstorm warnings out there. Heat advisories out there too, for parts of Idaho. So that's the National Weather Service. Now we're quickly going to be looking at the radar for the next 10 days. This will be like a U.S. forecast here. It's been a long time since I've been a U.S. forecast. So, as you can tell, within the next couple hours, we will be having these strong storms here for Oklahoma. That's why we had those flash flood watches there. And we will have some light rain for the Pacific Northwest there. As we go in the next 3 days, we won't have too much different, really. We're just going to have that rain here for the Northwest, and for parts of the areas of the plains, we could have some severe weather there. It's not going to be incredibly different, but we will actually have on August 13th a huge severe weather outbreak based on this for parts of the Wisconsin, Iowa, and Illinois area. We can actually have some severe weather and then some light rain out there for the south, for the southern Gulf there. And then if we go on, that will actually bring in some incredibly heavy rainfall on the 14th of August. Actually, incredibly a lot of rainfall for just the eastern part of the country in general, especially the northeast. So that's looking forward to having some severe weather, and that band will stretch all the way to Colorado, bringing some light rain. So again, if you just look for your area, and if you're in the green, then that's where you can actually have some rain. On the 15th of July, we can actually have some more rain out here for parts of the southeast. It's going to be actually quite some wet conditions there. And as we go on, we will actually have possibly on the 16th of 17th of August have some rain showers and some possible severe weather for the Midwest and Central Plains here. Northern Plains. So that's a quick look at the radar. Again, there wasn't really a whole lot to look at there. But again, if you're in the green, all this is basically what's gonna look like again through the next 10 days. Again, this wall changed very fast. And then if you guys were wondering, the 16th of August, we're gonna just have some rain there for southern Georgia, maybe some showers out there if you're in northern Georgia. But again, just look for your area and then just look at the date. It's gonna be right here if you want to know that. So now we're gonna be looking at the 6 to 10 day outlook, and boy, does this show some really, really hot numbers out here through all the way to the Minnesota area, all the way to the South Central, guys. And look at these colors. We actually have incredibly warm temperatures right here for Texas. I can't imagine how hot it's going to be over there. We actually have possibly 8 degrees above average. And look, we are actually going to have that cool down, though, for the West and the Northeast. We're finally going to have that cool down in the, into the south or the northwest there. We're finally going to have that cool down what they needed. Not going to be incredibly cold, maybe 2 to 3 to possibly maybe at most 7 degrees below average. We're going to be looking into those numbers in the next slide or in 2 slides from now. But boy, are we going to have really, really warm number here. So if you are from this light color all the way to this color, you're actually in the warm. And if you're in this right here, we're actually going to be seeing the warmest temperatures right here. It's incredibly hot there. We're going to have some more, possibly 5 degrees above average for the southeast there. And then, so the light blue, sorry, the light orange, those first two shades are about 1 to 2 degrees above average. Then this is about 2 to 3, 4 to 5, and then 5 or 6 plus. And then same thing happens with the below average. Won't be seeing incredibly cold numbers there. About maybe again 2 to 7 degrees below average, but boy will it feel nice. And it's actually kind of rare, the one that's actually going to happen the end of August, that can actually bring incredibly cold numbers there. It's going to be 3 times as cold as this, and that's going to be something really rare that we're going to be talking about next week. Though again, widespread warm warm temperatures all the way from the southwest to the northeast coast and to all the way to the Midwest across the south southern Gulf there coast. Again, guys, it's really gonna be bad for Texas though. Now we're gonna be looking at the 8 to 14 day outlook. Let me just click that really fast there. So this is the 8 to 14 day outlook. So all this is gonna go from the 16th of August to the 22nd of August. We're still gonna have those cold temperatures out here for the Pacific or for the western part of the country, the Northwest. But we actually had these warmer temperatures start to reach the Northeast. As you can tell, it isn't as bad as the 6 to 10 day outlook. We are not going to have that much of a change for Texas, but it will spread though. For sure, it's going to spread to New Mexico and Oklahoma, this heat, the worst of it. So we could have those excessive heat warnings come out one more time until we start to have the fall months come in. So this might be the last time we see excessive heat warnings for Texas. It's actually a relief me saying that. Again, we could actually have a surprise heat wave before fall, like maybe the end of August or the beginning of September. We might have a surprise attack of heat, but for now, I'm gonna say this is the last heat wave this bad for Texas. We will have some warmer temperatures out here for the Ohio Valley. The worst of it will start to move a bit more north again. The warm air will start to move a bit more north here in the ridges right here, and that'll be keeping the cold air in placement. But again, the warm air will be moving up and continuing to bring in extremely warm temperatures. So now we're gonna be looking at the 2 temp anomaly here. Let me move down a little bit, like this. Let me try to go like this here. So this is actually today. We will be seeing some colder temperatures out here for the plains here, especially for parts of Wichita there. Possibly 12 degrees below average. Again, we were having these warmer temperatures right now for the Pacific Northwest there. But that would all change with these cold air start to move north here, potentially bringing an effect there. Again, we will be seeing these warmer temperatures for the Southeast and South Central today. Let's go all the way to the 10th of August and make sure I get there. So the 10th of August, this is the 10th of August. Yes, 10th of August, we will actually be seeing these colder temperatures start to get a bit more colder for parts of the West. Again, California, you're finally getting the cold front here, possibly 12 degrees below average. It's going to be widespread cold air from all the way to the Southwest to the all the way to the North. It's widespread warm, widespread cold air. For parts of South Dakota here, North Dakota, and Montana, you can expect possibly 14 degrees below average. And again, the above average will stay or will be blocked. Basically, this ridge will just continue to block it here. As we go on, though, further into the week there, as we go into the 12th of July, or August, sorry, it will be bringing some widespread warmer temperatures, though, for much of the plains here. And the cooler temperatures, well, we also have the cooler temperatures, though, but it won't be as cold, though. And then we will have this cold there to continue to push, though. But, again, this warm air won't last all of August. Again, it's going to be all the way to the next 14 days when we will see the cold air start to come back, though. But we will see a lot of cold air for the northern part of the country. But if you live in the south, central, it's not your favorite type of thing you want to see there. Again, for southern Texas, you could expect 12 degrees above average. As we go on to the 15th of August, let me actually go to the 17th of August here. We can actually see some warmer temperatures start to spread again. This is when the warmer temperatures will spread to the west, and then we'll have the cold air for the east again. So if you're in the southeast, you will see your cold air back again. And then as we go into the 18th of July, or August, sorry, we'll have this cold air from now for the east and for the west, and then the warmer for the more kind of somewhat of the west part of the country there. But finally, for the northeast and the midwest, you'll have your cold air again. Then this cold air will come back into Georgia for my area, and then it will turn to the regular pattern. It should go back to normal. We should have the cold temperatures for the east coast, and then the warmer temperatures for the west coast. So it should go back to normal by the 19th of July. And then again, we could have actually some incredibly cold fronts to push in through the United States. Look at this. Look at the 20th of August here. Extremely widespread cold temperatures. About 60% of the country there. We'll be seeing possibly 16 degrees below average. Texas, those areas will be getting the cold air. And finally, and then it will become more widespread and getting to Georgia. And it looks like, though, we will have another warm front, though, by the 23rd of August for parts of the areas in the Midwest, and then we should have that cold air to come back, though. Now, we're going to be quickly looking at the European one, but the European doesn't really take that long because it's basically the same thing, but kind of different. So if we go the next 18 hours again, we'll have that cold air here, or warm air, sorry, for the South Central, and that cold air for the West and for the Northern Plains. Only about 11 degrees, only about 7 degrees to 6 degrees below average for Minnesota. And then this is when we have that second blast that brings incredibly cold temperatures for California and Oregon. And then that brings in the warmer temperatures again for South Central. So, for example, Texas, you can see possibly 9 degrees above average. And then California will be seeing possibly 14 degrees below average. It's actually incredibly cold there. And then this cold will not stay down that long. It should leave within the next couple hours after it arrives. But the heat will last a lot longer, like usual, up to possibly 11 degrees above average. We go to this 15th of August, we will have some cold air start to become widespread. Now we are having the West, the Midwest, and the Central Plains start to get that cold air. And then we have an incredibly rare sight. This is the rare sight we're talking about here, guys. This is actually a polar blast. This is what you see here in for November. Look at that cold air, up to 20 degrees below average there. It's incredibly cold there, guys. It's going to be a really rare sight, and I hope to make a video about it. So, guys, I hope you guys enjoy the video. Please do not forget to like and subscribe to my YouTube channel, guys, and bye. Have a great day.